So yesterday we were discussing what an equilibrium is, what makes an equilibrium, how reactions achieve or try to go towards an equilibrium state. Now, so once we reach equilibrium, we know a few things about equilibriums. Once you achieve equilibrium, first of all, by definition, it's called a dynamic equilibrium because the reaction doesn't stop. It's just that the rate at which the reaction goes forward and backward is going to be equal. Okay? So the rate of the forward and backward reactions are equal. That's one of the first properties. The second property is that the concentration of the constituents. Constituents, this is point number two, are basically the reactants and products. They will all exist in that closed system and they will not change. This is slide number four still, okay? And it's dynamic state. Meaning at the molecular level, opposing changes, meaning forward and backward reaction are continuously taking place. Even though the amount doesn't change, the reaction is still happening at the molecular level. And later on in O-levels also, we have done this, that the position of the equilibrium is sensitive to changes in pressure, temperature, concentration. And that's why you applied Le Chatelier's principle to figure out the effect of those factors on equilibrium positions. And the equilibrium can be attained from either side. This was the example from, let's say, we did esterification from acids and alcohols. So you can make an ester from acids and alcohols or hydrolyze an ester into acid and alcohol. Either way, you can achieve the same equilibrium starting from the left-hand side or the right-hand side. So there are some properties of equilibriums. Now, what we want to discuss is that we can measure equilibrium positions. Now, to do this, I want to discuss the idea of what law is in science. Law versus hypothesis versus theory. Law is basically a statement of facts we know to always be true, but we can't explain the underlying science or the core science behind it. The main reasons why. For example, the law of gravitational energy or gravitational attraction. Your body is attracted to the center of the earth or masses like the earth attracts the sun or the sun attracts the earth and the moon. We know they attract. We just don't know why. We know they attract. Just like we know unlike charges attract each other and like charges repel each other. We know they exist. We know the truth is there, but we can't explain it. So there's another such law exists in chemistry called the equilibrium law, which basically is a measure of the equilibrium position. We do not know why, we just know it is. So we use that to our advantage, really. A theory is something that has an explanation. And that explanation has been tested over by multiple times. Hence the term theory. It has got data and verifiable data, and then explanation has also been in line with that verifiable data. Unless there's a better explanation comes across later, till that moment, it is the best explanation we have. Here, we have no theory. We actually have law. That's why in physics, you'll have theory of relativity, but because you can explain that. But the law of gravitational attraction, because you can't explain. So, now, just for a little bit of science. What exists on slide number 5, and I'll talk about that in a minute, because I don't want to go to the variable part yet. I want to talk about a couple of examples first, especially from the video that I asked you guys to see yesterday. Very hyper-energetic person from that course online. You guys got to see the video? Yeah, that course is a great way to revise general science in life. It's brilliant, by the way. Now, anyways, so he's talking about the Haber's process, and we all know the Haber's process from O-levels, which is N2 plus 3H2 becoming 2NH3. We know this equation to exist. We know this equilibrium to exist. What does equilibrium law state? The equilibrium law is something that we've discovered. And what we have discovered is that the ratio or the fraction of the right-hand side key products, key concentration, meaning the concentration of the right-hand side raised to the coefficient, the stoichiometric coefficient, meaning raised NH3 raised to the power 2 over the left-hand side, which is N2 and H2. So over N2 to the power 1, because this coefficient is 1 and this coefficient is 3. So into H2's concentration to the power 3. We know this to be always going to be a constant. No matter, aaj karo, kal karo, agle saal karo, marne ke baad aapke bachche kare, yehi ratio aana hai. Haan, only at specific temperatures. The only thing that one can vary this value is temperature. So, agar aaj 25 degree pe, aur agle saal bhi 25 degree pe reaction, jitna bhi kiya, chote drum mein kiya, bade company mein kiya, wherever you do it, no matter how much you do it, the ratio of the concentrations raised to the stoichiometric powers is going to be a constant. Constants are normally used, denoted by the letter K. In the American boards, this is called K of the equilibrium. We will be, you know, a little more specific, but this is because this is the K of the equilibrium in terms of concentration. Because these square brackets will always mean concentration. Concentration means moles per mq. So, this is known as Kc, the K in terms of concentration. Now, just to let you know, Kc bhi hoga A1s mein, Kp bhi hoga A1s mein, that'll be in terms of pressure of gases. Phir hum A levels mein ye bhi karte hain, A2 mein, Kw, Ka, Kb bhi hota hai, Kpc bhi hota hai, Ksp bhi hota hai. These are all equilibrium constants. There'll be so many equilibriums we'll be doing in second year. This is water ka equilibrium. This is weak acids ka equilibrium like ethanoic acid. This is weak bases like ammonia ka equilibrium. This is partition coefficient. This is when things dissolve in two immiscible solvents like oil and water. This is when salts dissolve in water partially. That's why you form precipitates in the lab theory. So, but our A1s is only this. So we'll focus on this, but your mind should be open ke this is going to come later also in second year. But today we'll only do it Kc. Because that's the most basic version of it. And what is Kc? Kc stands for equilibrium constant. The constant of the equilibrium, which states that the right-hand side over the left-hand side is constant. Obviously, somebody decided that you could have had said the left-hand side over the right-hand side also. It's just what you decide goes on the right-hand side on the left-hand side. So, this is equation specific. Because you could have written the same equation like this. Kr ammonia decomposes to give me N2 and 3H2. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Chemically, this and this is the same thing. Because equilibrium can be achieved from either side. But Kc is equation specific. So, if iska Kc ye hai, iska Kc hoga, again, jo iski right hand side hai, which is what? N2 into H2 cube. The 3 will nothing be there, it will just be cubed. Over NH3 square. So, this will be the Kc for this, and this will be the Kc for this. And what you will realize is that this is the reciprocal of this. And iske units alag honge, iske units alag honge. And you can even figure out the units. How do you figure out the units for this? On the numerator, you have two concentration terms. On the denominator, you have four. Now, you can do it by the longer way, which is, acha yaar, numerator pe moles per dm cube squared hai. Denominator mein moles per dm cube into moles per dm cube cube hai. And then I'll simplify. What I find easier is to decide, you know what, I'm just dealing with concentrations. So the top is concentration squared. The bottom is concentration into concentration cube. I simplify to realize that I only have 1 over concentration squared, which is concentration to the power minus 2, which then gives me moles minus 2 dm 6. Because concentration is moles per dm cube. Usme minus 2 se multiply kar doge to ye aa jayega. Now obviously, iska ye hai, to iska ulta hoga iska. The other example that I gave. So, Now, I'm just giving some examples here, okay? Then we'll go to the slide number 5 with the actual stuff. So now, I can even look at another equilibrium. Can I change this? So I'm going to actually give you two more equilibriums. One of them is, how about this one? SO2 plus half O2 becoming SO3. This is seen in the contact process. This is the oxidation of sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide catalyzed by either oxides of nitrogen and air. That's why oxides are bad of nitrogen. They catalyze SO2 to SO3, which forms acid rain. But it's equilibrium. So it's equilibrium ka case hi ho sakta hai. So kya hoga iska KC? What we just did talk about KC, for an equilibrium, by law, the equilibrium constant is the ratio of the right-hand side concentration over the left-hand side raised to each of their coefficients. So O2 ka power ho gaya half. For anybody who doesn't know what half power is, it is under root, square root. Okay? Now this is going to be different, the value, if I had represented my equilibrium like this, which is absolutely correct to write also like this. Iska KC hota SO3 squared over SO2 squared into O2. This will be different than this, because this will be specific to this equation, and this is the same equation but twice of that same equation. So how you write the equation, the KC is respect to that. The KC is just the expression. So, and in mein units kya honge, upper moles per dm cube and niche moles per dm cube, they cancel. You only have in this case 1 over moles half dm minus 3 over 2, which you can take on top, it'll become moles minus half dm 3 over 2. But you will have to write the units. It's science. Unless, of course, the units cancel out. And that is possible. Can I show that to you also? That is possible with the equilibrium we were talking about yesterday a bit, where ethanoic acid plus ethanol react to make the ester and water. I'm writing the word ester to represent the whole ester. I just am lazy. I don't want to write the whole thing. So in this particular case, the KC would be what? Again, right-hand side ki concentrations, ester ki concentration into water ki concentration. Now, I'm taking water's concentration here because yaha reactants are not in aqueous form. They're liquids. So the concentration is for the overall volume of the solution. Ye charo ko mix karke volume aata hai. So I will take water here. And we will talk about that later. Don't worry too much if I said something you don't understand about water right now. Don't worry about that right now. As long as you write all the reactants and products right now. And you do that, and what do you get? Now in this case, this is the KC expression. And iski units kya honge? In this case, the units will cancel out. Now, what do I mean by writing all of this, by the way? I forgot to mention that when I wrote the KC expression, I wrote this ratio. What I said was, the idea was that the concentration of ester into water over acid into alcohol will be a constant. Which concentration? The concentration after they've achieved equilibrium. Not before. This is the concentration at equilibrium, which is why aap aaj equilibrium banao, kal banao, 10 times moles leke banana shuru karo, end mein jo ratio aana hai at the point of equilibrium will always be a constant. That's the beauty by which we will use to find yields for things. So all of the, we just saw this, all of these examples, jo yahan dekhi thi, ammonia wale, SO2, SO3, these were basically, what I was saying was that the value for KC, for even the Haber's process, is that the ratio of the concentrations of ammonia, nitrogen, and hydrogen at and after they've achieved equilibrium, that value will be a constant. Now, so generically, this is what we're looking at. That for any equilibrium, this is slide number 5 now, for any equilibrium, If you have A plus B becoming C and D, here A and B are the left-hand side and B, C and D are the right-hand side. And W, X, Y, and Z are your stoichiometric coefficients. So, okay, equilibrium constant or the equilibrium law states that the equilibrium will be a constant where the ratio of C to the power Y into D to the power Z over A to the power W into B to the power X, that ratio will be a
constant.
Now, what you will have to do, which is the easy part, is that you'll have to calculate the value for Kc. And sometimes they will give you the value for Kc and you will have to calculate the value of these guys. So today, first we'll calculate the value for Kc from a couple of examples, and then using that, we'll find the value for some of these later. So the square brackets remind you that they always denote concentration at equilibrium. And Kc is known as the equilibrium
constant.
Now, this will be for later, but we do not include solids in our equilibrium expression. Because solids don't mix in the solution and their concentration are always going to be constant. But don't worry about that part yet today. We'll talk about that later. So for example, if you've been given an equilibrium, and this is slide number 6, let's say this is the equilibrium of the contact process. SO2 plus O2 becoming SO3. If they have given you this, and they are telling you that jo humne equilibrium banaya, banne ke baad, we have these concentrations of each of the three. Like SO2 is this much, O2 is this much, and SO3 is this much. And therefore, how do I find the value for Kc? I will write the expression of Kc, and then plug in these values for the concentrations of SO3, O2, and SO2. So this will be 0.15 for this guy, but that will be squared over SO2 squared into O2. SO2 will be this squared, O2 will be this. So that's what you do. You write the expression, SO3 squared over SO2 into O2, plug in the values and solve. Along with the value, you need to also have the units calculated. In this case, there's two concentration terms on the top, three at the bottom, the twos cancel out. You live left with 1 over concentration, which is really 1 over moles per dm cube, which means moles minus 1 dm cube. All right, we always write moles first and then dm cube. Okay? So we'll see that example. Now, yeah, there's some other examples of Kc expressions here. Like this one would be Hi squared over H2 into I2. And in this case, units will cancel out. I've already done some of these already. Theek hai? Now, the first question about calculation. This is on slide number 8. Now, I don't want you turning anything anywhere but slide number 8. You focus on slide number 8. Theek hai? Now, consider this equilibrium. I'm telling you that P is reacting with 2Q, random element reactants, making R and S. And the data given to you, this equation is the equilibrium equation. What you will be given in terms of actual amounts to react or things to react would not always have been in the ratio of the equation. This is the equation ka ratio of reaction. That even if this is equilibrium, 1P would react with 2Q to make R and S. But the information given doesn't always have to follow the ratio of the reaction. Because what the information is given is that initially they're giving you 1 mole of P and 1 mole of Q. So the kind of way you'll get information is that you will realize that, okay, yahan kya ho raha hai, hum iska Kc, is reaction ka hum Kc nikalenge. Uske liye, you'll have to know what you start with. Sometimes you'll start with just the reactants, but you can also have just started with only the products or a mix of both. Because equilibrium can be achieved from either direction or even putting all the things together and mixing, and then they make a new equilibrium, whatever they do. So equilibrium can start from anywhere. So you have to understand, okay, where are they starting this equilibrium from? They're mixing 1 mole of P and 1 mole of Q, which means the equilibrium is starting from the left-hand side. So this will go forward and eventually form an equilibrium where I'll have some of this and I will have some of this left. Khatam nahi hoga kuch bhi. But the first thing you'll realize is that, acha, change kis taraf aa raha hai? Is it going right or left? In this case, since they only mentioned one mole of P and one mole of Q, you know ke humne ye molecules diye the. Which means, in ye kitne honge shuru mein? At the start of the experiment, this would be nothing, zero, because I have taken only this. Now, once the equilibrium has been reached, somehow they figured out ke once reaction khatam ho gaya, but it's dynamic equilibrium, no values are changing. Suddenly at that moment they discovered, they found out through techniques we will not worry about, that one of the reactants, P ke itne moles bach gaye hain. So that means at equilibrium, P ke still 0.6 moles bach gaye hain. Ab hume sab ke moles nikalne hain. How many moles of Q, R and S using this information are present at equilibrium and what is the Kc? Now, this is what we do. This is what you already have drawn already in slide number 5, 6, but I want you to look at the board first. So I isolate all my reactants and my products first. And this is a table. Literally, this is a table, moles table for all equilibrium reactions. You do this every time, you'll get no question wrong. You skip this sometimes or even parts of this, chances are you can get questions wrong. Now, this is three part ice. Think of it as the ice table. You already have that. The first part is the initial moles. The initial moles. The second part is the change in moles. Now the change in moles comes from how much reacted. Now what I mean is, dekho, initially they had told me that I have taken one mole of P and one mole of Q. What that would tell me that initially when the reaction started, there is zero moles of R and zero moles of S. And I know that the moles at equilibrium for P was how many?
0.6.
Ye to information mujhe examined, question mein mil chuka hai. Now, I really need the moles of Q, R and S. Why? So then I can find the concentrations at equilibrium. Because jab mole hoga, to concentration niklengi. And then once I have the concentration, can I actually put them in the Kc expression to find Kc? So I want the concentrations. But for that, I need the moles. But I can't think of the moles here are not going to be in the reaction ratio. Please understand that. The reaction ratio is only and only used in when they react and there's a change. What I mean is that initially moles P ke 1 the, baad mein end mein 0.6 baj gaye. So net, kitna na react kar diya? 0.4. They're still reacting, but the net change, that's why you can think in terms of reaction, but the technical term is change. The change in moles, the net change in moles. In my slides, it says moles reacted. But generally, even if they give you the table in the exams, they will never have this row given. You will have to create this row, the change. So now I know, ki agar one mole the initially aur n mein 0.6 bache, kitna react kiya?
0.4.
I know it's painful and I'm doing very slow. Because then I will know, I'm doing this slow, so I don't have to do this again. So 1 minus 0.6, kitna ho gaya? 0.4. Now this guy, that means the net amount of P reaction was 0.4. This will react in the ratio of the equation. Because it says 1 P, if it were to react, will react with how many Qs? 2. So 0.4 will react with 0.8 Q. To produce how much of R? And how much of S? Acha, that means if 0.8 reacted of Q, I only had 1, how much of that is left? How much?
0.2.
And please, this is what you have to find. These will not always be in the ratio of the reaction. The reacted row, the middle, the change row, the change will be in the ratio of the equation. This will be what's left. So you start with 1.8 reacted, so 0.2 ban gaya. And R tha 0, but you made 0.4. So how much is here then?
0.4.
And this 0. And they've given you volume. All of them were in what volume? 1 dmq. So basically, the concentrations were 0.6, 0.2, 0.4, and 0.4. Then what do? You plug them all in the Kc expression, which will be R into S over P into Q square. This 2 was used in two places, as a ratio in the change reacted row, and at the end as a power in the Kc expression. And you plug in this, all of these, and you'll get the value for Kc. And if you did that, the answer will be 6.67, because it will be 0.4 into 0.4 over 0.6 into 0.2 squared, which will be 6.67. And there will be units, obviously. Units kya honge? Okay, so now, if you look at the example on slide number 11, it's the whole thing is solved, but I'd rather you look at the board and not the question. The question was that 1 mole of ethanoic acid and 1 mole of ethanol have been mixed to form an equilibrium with their ester and water. And at the end of equilibrium, it was found that 2/3 of the acid has reacted, which means in my initial change and equilibrium, initial may you got CH3CO2H and you got the alcohol and you got ester and you got water. Okay, so yeah, so kya tha iska? Initial moles say 1100. The change or in your C is reacted. This is initial. But we know that they said that how many had reacted away in the question? 2/3. So 2/3 of 1 is 2/3. 2/3. But this row will be in the ratio of reaction, the only row. So 2/3 will react with 2/3 to make 2/3 and 2/3. So what will be left at equilibrium? 1 minus 2/3, which will be 1/3. 1/3, 0 plus 2/3, and 0 plus 2/3. So whenever the arrow is, the reactants will be minus and the products will be added. Haan, assumption is ki ye reaction right pe ja raha hai. Left pe bhi ja sakta hai, hum baad mein dekhenge. But that will be given from the data in the question. Having this, what do I get my Kc as? The right hand side, now isme volume diya hua aapko? Nahi. So the concentration of ester into the concentration of water divided by the concentration of acid into the concentration of alcohol. I'm writing V because whatever the volume is, 1/4 is all the same for all. And not always, but many times, it'll cancel out. The V's will cancel out. Upar do and niche do hai cancel ho gaye. Then even the 3's will cancel out in this case. This 3 with this 3, this 3 with this 3. You're left with 2 into 2 over 1 into 1, which will give you a Kc of 4. So this has a Kc of 4. So the idea is initial, reacted, and at equilibrium. You following? Yeah? Now, one last thing I want to introduce to you, because you have a weekend coming up, and I want to give you more questions and more explanations later. But I want to just introduce the idea so that we can continue with this. So I'm going to skip the example 3 and go to slide number 14. Yeah, we saw that skipping this. Slide number 14. Now, this is the real purpose of Kc. Ek to hai ke we have to calculate Kc. The other is we can use Kc to know how much reacted, because that is the real need. Because once we've calculated Kc, kal, parso, har saal same rana, because it's a constant. Now that I know my constant, tomorrow I can use that for prediction. For example, I have a reaction between H2 and I2 to make HI. And for a particular temperature, we figured ke bhai Kc is 49. Because this may, the units cancel out, this has no units. The temperature is certain temperature, us pe Kc 49 aa raha hai. Or I want to know, now I know Kc is 9. And I tell you that, bhai, I've actually also taken 1 mole of each of these. And I want to know, kitna HI banta hai. Now, if this reaction was in completion, 1 and 1 will make 2. Because the ratio is 1 is to 1 makes 2. But that won't be the case here because it's an equilibrium. But we have to use this to figure out how much will be left at equilibrium. But isko karne ke liye hum wahi technique istemal karenge. Kaun si?
Ice, baby.
So the equation is H2 plus I2 becoming 2HI. Aapko khali jagah di hai slide pe, to wo istemal kar le. So I have H2, I have I2, and I have HI. And I know my Kc is how much? 49. So in slide number 14, you have space, you make this. You write the reactants and you write initial change ice ka or reacted and moles at equilibrium. Hum sara kaam moles mein karenge, usko end mein hum karenge convert to concentration. First moles. So initial moles kya diye mujhe? 1, 1 and therefore 0. And that's all I've been given, nothing else. But I know that whatever reacted will react with the ratio 1 is to 1 to make 2. Now when I'm given Kc and I need to know what to find at equilibrium, I will take a variable. I will say, well, X. Let's assume that X moles of H2 reacted, or the change in H was X. So the change in I would also be, because the ratio is 1 is to 1. And this is the only row that is going to be in the ratio of the reaction. If that's in the ratio, how much HI will they make?
2X.
So what's left at equilibrium? 1 minus X and 2X. And since the Kc is HI squared over H2 into I2. Acha, now, what about the concentration at equilibrium? Volume kitna tha? 10. So 1 minus x over 10. 1 minus x over 10. 2x over 10. And once I have this, I plug this into my Kc. Kc kya hoga? Hi square over H2 into I2. Hi squared is 2x over 10 whole square over 1 minus x over 10 into 1 minus x over 10. And I know this equals to what? 49. And I start to simplify. First of all, you do not expand. They don't expect you to solve quadratics. So you don't expand. You can solve it simply. First of all, you'll see that niche upar bhi 10 squared ho raha hai, niche bhi 10 ho raha squared. So the 10s cancel out. You can first simplify this. Like I will say 2x over 10 whole square divided by 1 minus x over 10 whole square. That equals to 49. The 10 and agar humne ye kar liya, to under root all sides, what do you get? 2x over 10, 1x over 10 equals to plus minus 7. Root of 49 is plus minus 7. Minus also. And then you can simplify the 10. What you left with? Is equal to plus minus 7. Now you solve for x. And you will be solving for two values for x. Ek mein hoga 2x, 1 minus x equals to plus 7. Ek mein hoga 2x or 1 minus x equals to minus 7. The above one will give you 2x equal to 7 minus 7x. 9x equals to 7. X equals to 7 over 9. The second one will give you 2x equals to minus 7 plus 7x. 5x. So x mein kya hoga? X will be 7 over 5. So either x is 7 over 9 or 7 over 5. But when I look at all my statements right here at the start, I only started with 1 or x react to y. So I know for sure x cannot be more than 1. Because shuru mein 1 se kiya tha maine. And here I have two values. One is 7 over 9, one is 7 over 5. So which will be the right value for x? 7 over 9. Now, I should tell you this, that every single Cambridge question so far in the last 15 years, mein, the answer for x has been what comes from the plus value of the under root. So if you are lazy, you just do that and that. But you need to realize that both are possible. And the reason why I'm saying that is because sometimes the assumption of the reaction going forward and backward is also made wrong. But again, all the Cambridge reactions so far, mein, if you write the equation they have given you, it's going to go forward. So, yeah. So that's the real use of KC. So I'm going to message you some of the questions that we gave the other class also for homework. This is from Equilibria worksheet number 4 first. They're the easier ones first. You do that over the weekend. I believe tomorrow might not be class. I'm not sure. I'll just check with the school. They are saying there is class, but they're saying, oh, half the school is not going to show up, so it's up to you. So that, I also don't want to call you guys when half the class is not here and then others not having class, so.